How's it going, guys? I know it's been a really, really long time. If you've been wondering where we've been at, that's what I'm going to be explaining in this video. But before we jump into it, I had to show you what our local rink looks like. Check it out. So where have we been for essentially the last 3-4 months? Now, of course, everyone knows what's going on in the world right now. That plays a massive factor in it. But something else that's kind of been happening since probably the beginning of 2020, even though we were posting a lot of videos, we were traveling at the start of 2020. I think we went to Spain, Switzerland. We were moving around a lot, giving you guys some pretty sweet content. But what started to happen is essentially this whole hockey thing started to feel a lot like a job where you're clocking in, clocking out, doing what you need to be doing. And I feel like why that's happened is a mixture of different things. Of course, COVID was the cherry on top of everything that's been going on. But this stems further back when we had a pretty tight network of players that we played with, because everyone knows that we all love the game, we love to play, but more so than that, it's about having a good time with the boys, as our good friend Steve says from Finland. But when the boys aren't there anymore, is it still a good time? And that's what I found myself going through. The core network of players that we had to go back, either if it was because of deployment going to Korea, for example, our good friend Tommy Moldenhauer, or our really good friend Lee Elias from Wraparound that you guys know. When these guys left the UK, which is where we all met, and went back to different countries and then eventually ending back up in the States, it meant that a lot of the tight people that we played with, including Jeff the Crazy Goalie, were now gone and back in America. And in addition to that, a lot of us that we used to play with started to take, you know, our actual careers that weren't hockey related much more seriously. And it meant that the guys that you like to play hockey with weren't really around that much. So in terms of putting content out, it was a case of getting on the ice, filming the videos, and then leaving. And what starts to happen is you slowly kind of start to take the game for granted and you forget why you fell in love with the game in the first place. Now, what I wanted to explain in this video is essentially where we've been, and hopefully this is something that other players are going through, some steps that you can take to hopefully correct that, because it's essentially exactly what I've just come through myself. Now, when you find yourself losing the passion, losing the drive for hockey, exactly like I did, I felt like the best thing for me to do would be to just take a little bit of a break. Because when you step away from something that you really enjoy doing and you completely sever ties with it, what happens very quickly is that you remember why you loved it, you remember why you missed it and why you were drawn to it. Now, of course, having a good group of friends around you that are also into hockey, that are gonna kind of help to egg you and pull you back into the game, helps massively. But of course, like I explained earlier on, when your core network of players leaves and then all of a sudden you're taking this very seriously as like a job and you're clocking in, clocking out, doing what you need to do, and then a global pandemic hits, all of the arenas are closed, nobody can play. It makes it very difficult to find the motivation to still create content, to still give you guys quality videos and genuine videos. Now, of course, what I could have done was still made videos, forced the videos through, but they wouldn't have been genuine. And that's just not the kind of person that I am. That's not the kind of creator that I am. So I felt the smartest thing to do would just be to take a little break. And like I said, what happens very quickly is you remind yourself of why you love the game in the first place. But while I was having a break, one of the things that really got me through kind of like rediscovering my love for the game was doing something completely different, which in my case was riding electric skateboards. Now, a lot of you guys have seen this in previous videos, but I'm a massive advocate for riding boards. I don't mean riding things like booster boards in a straight line back and forth. I mean riding big boards, all-terrain boards, carving, shredding, sliding. It's probably one of my biggest passions next to hockey. Now, doing that was great because it still brought me all of the same sensations and kind of like feelings that hockey brought for me while I was on the ice, which is when you're on the ice, well, when there is eventually ice behind us, you don't think about anything that's going on in the outside world. All you think about is the game. And that's exactly what happens when I jump on my board. When I'm riding, when I'm shredding, when I'm carving, I think of nothing else but the experience on the board. And it's great for helping you to reset, for being able to clear your head, being able to think clearly. And most importantly, it helps you deal with stress, especially with a global pandemic happening. Now, if you're curious about the boards that I ride, it's called the GTR Bamboo, and it's from a company called Evolve, who are Australian. And in the midst of riding these boards and kind of moving away from hockey, I actually started a second YouTube channel, which a few of you guys have actually found because I've seen comments on the second channel saying, "That's Chris from Hockey Tutorial. What's he doing on a skateboard?" If you want to see what we're up to on that channel, the link will be down below in the video description. But if you're the type of person that likes to get your adrenaline going, you like speed, then riding electric boards that can do upwards of 30 miles an hour is definitely a good way to do it if you're unable to get on the ice and play. So I'll link my other channel down below in the video description if you want to check it out. But coming back to what I was saying earlier on, it's really important to have something else that you're passionate about as well as hockey. Of course, if you're trying to take hockey seriously, you want it to be a profession, you want to play professionally, then of course you do need to put in a lot of hours, and it can get tedious, and you can slowly start to find yourself sometimes falling out of love with it or forgetting why you're doing it in the first place. Or in my case, it can start to feel a little bit like you're just clocking in and clocking out. Having something else that you're passionate about isn't gonna kind of stop you from developing what you need to develop in hockey. It's just nice to be able to step away from the game, even if it's for a couple of months or a few weeks, just to do something else. And then when it's time to get back into hockey, back into the swing of things, you'll be more energized, you'll be able to think clearer, and you'll be more passionate and involved with what you're doing just because of having a little bit of a break. So it's definitely not something that I've found as a negative. It's something that has benefited me quite a lot, just being able to step away, clear my head, refocus, re-energize, and then step back into the game. So what's next? What's coming? Now, if you guys are thinking that I'm gonna stop making YouTube videos, that's definitely not the case. We're at the rink right now speaking to the management over here to figure out when there's gonna be ice, when we can get back on the ice and start filming, which is looking like around the middle of May, 17th to the 18th of May. So I'm very, very keen to get back on the ice because we have a ton of videos coming. Now, of course, some of the things that you can expect, we all know that the larger manufacturers have new skates coming out. I don't wanna give too much away, but we already have all of these products in the office. And it's been very, very tough not posting them on social media, but we have them. The videos are going to be coming out. We've got a lot of guides coming. We've got, I think, our first trip out of the United Kingdom since the third lockdown in the UK, which is going to be to Germany. So we've got a lot of stuff coming up that we're very, very keen to share with you. But most importantly, my friend Josh, who is one of the reasons that I got into hockey as heavily as I did just before I started posting hockey videos. If you've been watching our videos long enough to know when I used to post ice skating videos, this is the guy that helped me get into hockey. We've decided that we are going to be creating a recreational team. Now, that team is going to be based in Cambridge in the United Kingdom. And we're trying to decide on the name, but I kind of feel like the name should be the Hockey Tutorial Recreational Team. And the idea behind that team is exactly what I discussed at the start of the video. It's not about being the best team in the rec league in the UK or putting up the most fierce competition. It's nothing about like that, nothing like that at all. It's about a solid, good group of guys that aren't going to give each other any crap, that aren't going to be overly aggressive, that just want to get together and have a good time on the ice. We want to bring back the experiences that we used to have playing in Peterborough with Phoenix, playing in Peterborough again with the Warbirds, where everyone got together. There was no drama. It was just a good time on the ice, a good time with the boys, and that's exactly what we're trying to bring back to Cambridge. Now, of course, if you want more information about this, if you live quite close and you want to see if you can get in on the team, there'll be a link down below in the video description to where you can reach out to us. But guys, a bunch of videos coming, travel videos are coming back, and maybe we've been talking to some companies that we haven't worked with very directly before, like maybe the NHL. But there's some insane stuff coming up that we can't wait to share with you guys. Just make sure that you keep watching, keep subscribing. Sorry that I've been gone for so long, but I'm back. The next video that drops is going to be in a few days' time from now, and it's going to be an actual video, not an update, a proper hockey video. So stay tuned for that, and thank you for supporting us all this time. Make sure you like the video, subscribe, and I'll catch you in the next one. Peace.